You're on mic number three. Testing 1 2. 1 2 2 2 2 2. Check your monitor on 1 2 3. Scott. Yep. Turn that up a little bit. Test 1 2. Testing 1 2 1 2. Turn it all the way off once. 1 2 1 2. That's not it. It's the third one. Testing 1 2. 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. Until you turn this all the way off, you're not controlling it. 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. No. Okay, that's. Are you in okay, channel one? Okay, now just turn the monitor all the way off once. Test 1 2 1 2 1 2. That's aux 3. Well, aux 1. 1 2 1 2 1 2. One, two, one, two, one, two. Was that it? Check 1 2.
It's one.
Oh, it's one? This is one? Okay.
That's off the monitor. That's off the monitor.
1 2, 1 2.
It's on the back monitor.
Okay, it's coming off the back monitor? Okay. All right, then go ahead and bring that monitor up. Bring that monitor up.
Number one, Tom. Bring one up.
On the monitor. 1 2.
This through the monitor.
Okay, you don't? Okay.
No, because we want this to be a condenser mic to pick up the whole group. But we do need the piano stronger through the monitor.
From God's word, and this is from Acts chapter 13, starting with verse 26. Brothers, sons of the family of Abraham, and those among you who fear God, to us has been sent the message of this salvation. For those who live in Jerusalem and their rulers, because they did not recognize him nor understand the utterances of the prophets, which are read every Sabbath, fulfilled them by condemning him. And though they found in him no guilt worthy of death, they asked Pilate to have him executed. And when they had carried out all that was written of him, they took him down from the tree and laid him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead, and for many days he appeared to those who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem, who are now his witnesses to the people. And we bring you the good news that what God promised to the fathers, this he has fulfilled to us, their children, by raising Jesus, as also it is written in the second Psalm, you are my son, today I have begotten you. And as for the fact that he raised him from the dead, no more to return to corruption, he has spoken in this way, I will give you the holy and sure blessings of David. Therefore, he says also in another psalm, you will not let your Holy One see corruption. For David, after he had served the purpose of God in his own generation, fell asleep and was laid with his fathers and saw corruption. But he whom God raised up did not see corruption. Let it be known to you, therefore, brothers, that through this man, forgiveness of sins is proclaimed to you. And by him, everyone who believes is freed from everything from which you could not be freed by the law of Moses. Beware, therefore, lest what is said in the prophets should come about. Look, you scoffers, be astounded and perish. For I'm doing a work in your days, a work that you will not believe, even if one tells it to you. As they went out, the people begged that these things might be told them the next Sabbath. And after the meeting of the synagogue broke up, many Jews and devout converts to Judaism followed Paul and Barnabas, who, as they spoke with them, urged them to continue in the grace of God. The next Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. And this is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
So we're going to, we need to turn up this mic that I'm speaking in a lot. It's going to pick up some wind every now and then. Then Scott also asked us to just have an opening prayer, and then we are the Clear family. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to announce us, but he asked me to do a prayer, so I'll start with that. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that we can be in this place and sing together and praise you together. And we pray that the message of these songs would go deep into all of our hearts who gather here today, and even those who are just passing by or passing through the park. Lord, I pray that when we hear your word, that it would go in and we would respond to it, to your glory and our good. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Lord, for you've done for me.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for all you've done.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for the times of trouble.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for protecting me.
Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, for what you've done.
Yeah.
one falls silent to hear the mighty trumpet split the eastern sky. Just imagine the King of all creation riding through the heavens, returning.
Thank you.
The next song we're going to sing is called Kaddish, and it is a song that is traditionally sung by Jewish people at the time of greatest sorrow, at the time of death. It's a song that's sung at mourning times, but it's a song of praise to God. And sometimes when life is hard, the only thing and the best thing that we can do is to praise God. So this is Kaddish, and some of the words are in Hebrew, but you'll hear them translated right afterwards.
Now, it's good to receive blessings, amen? How many are blessed to be out in the sunshine today? And how many are blessed to be able to be out in a park, singing, listening to music, having a festival, talking about Jesus? Yeah. Now, how many of you have heard it said, faith without works is dead? Have you heard that before? Faith without works is dead. And in Matthew 25, there's a little story Jesus tells. He says, when he finally arrives, blazing in beauty, and all his angels with him, the Son of Man will take his place on his glorious throne. Then all the nations will be arranged before him, and he will sort the people out, much as a shepherd sorts out sheep and goats, putting sheep to his right and goats to his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, enter, you who are blessed by my Father, take what's coming to you in this kingdom. It's been ready for you since the world's foundation, and here's why. I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was homeless and you gave me a room. I was shivering and you gave me clothes. I was sick and you stopped to visit. I was in prison and you came to me. Then those sheep are going to say, Master, what are you talking about? When did we ever see you hungry and feed you thirsty and give you a drink? And when did we ever see you sick or in prison and come to you? Then the king will say, I'm telling you the solemn truth. Whenever you did one of these things to someone overlooked or ignored, that was me. You did it to me. And then he will turn to the goats, the ones on his left, and say, get out, worthless goats. You're good for nothing but the fires of hell. And why? Because I was hungry and you gave me no meal. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. I was homeless and you gave me no bed. I was shivering and you gave me no clothes. Sick and in prison and you never visited. And then those goats are going to say, Master, what are you talking about? When did we ever see you hungry or thirsty or homeless or shivering or sick or in prison and didn't help? And he will answer them, I'm telling the solemn truth. Whenever you failed to do one of these things to someone who was being overlooked or ignored, that was me. You failed to do it to me. Then those goats will be herded to their eternal doom, but the sheep to their eternal reward. And so, my friends, we always must test our relationship with Jesus. Are we being faithful to Jesus, or are we trying to save our own butts?
Yeah. blessed. All things are done by his will. He spoke to the sea, and the sea stood still. Now ain't that a witness for my Lord? Ain't that a witness for my Lord? Ain't that a witness for my Lord? My soul is a witness for my Lord. Now there was a man of the Pharisees. His name was Nicodemus, and he didn't believe. The same came to Christ by night, wanted to be taught out of human sight. Nicodemus was a man, desired to know how a man can be born when he is old. Christ told Nicodemus as a friend, man, you must be born again. He said, marvel not, man, if you want to be wise, repent, believe, and be baptized, and you'll be a witness for my Lord. You'll be a witness for my Lord. You'll be a witness for my Lord. My soul is a witness for my Lord. You read about Samson from his birth, strongest man that ever lived on earth. Way back yonder in ancient times, he killed 10,000 of the Philistines. Then old Samson went wandering about. Samson's strength was never found out, till his wife sat upon his knee. She said, tell me where your strength lies, if you please. Well, old Samson's wife, she talked so fair. Samson said, cut off of my hair, shave my head just as clean as your hand, and my strength will come like a natural man. Oh, Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. My soul is a witness for my Lord.
Clear. For those of you who just came, we're the Clear family, and we're very grateful to be here today.
Down people in your name.
Is the Lord our God, almighty, omnipotent majesty, the Most High God. This same God that fashioned the universe and called the world into being knows you by name. He has ordained this time in your life, this very minute, this exact second. The Father is concerned with all that concerns you. He knows your heart. He knows your struggles. He has seen you in times of incredible victory. He has been there at the times when you have been overwhelmingly defeated, calling you by name. crying out to you to cast your cares upon him. He calls out to you now with a still small voice. Come to me, all you who are tired and weary with cares. Find rest in my arms. Come home.
If you hunger in the wilderness for a peace that your heart knew before, have you wandered finding something less when inside you've been longing for more? Do you remember how it used to be when you lived your life more abundantly? Come home, if you're tired and weary, come home. The Father is waiting to
I don't know if y'all can hear the cowbell.
But we need more cowbell.
I will ask my God to move. I speak the name. it's all that I can do. In desperation, I'll seek heaven and pray this for you. I pray for your healing, that circumstances would change. I pray that the fear inside would flee in Jesus' name. I pray that a breakthrough would happen today. I pray miracles over your life in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Speak your name like all the authority, declaring blessings, every promise. He is faithful to keep. I speak your name, no grave could ever hold. He is greater, he is stronger, he's the God of possible. I pray for your healing, and circumstances will change. I pray that the fear inside would flee in Jesus' name. Today, I pray miracles over your life in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
Oh. Come believe it, come receive it,
come receive it.
Oh, the power of the Spirit.
Wasn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Amen.
They passed the audition.
All right. So who can tell me what their name is? All right. So that you know when you talk to us about who was here this year and who you want to see again, because how many of you want to hear them again next year? Yeah. So that was awesome. So that's the Clear Family Singers, because you can hear them clear down the river, right? So, is Eric McDaniel here? That's who's supposed to be next. I do not see him. So, now you come up, Steve. You do your thing. We'll see if we can find Eric. And then I'll talk to Andre if Eric's not here.
All right, I'm making myself at home. Good to be here today, isn't it? Beautiful day. God has blessed us with a beautiful, beautiful day. Beautiful singing. the Clear Family Singers. If you enjoyed them, give them another round of applause today. Well, here we are. We find ourselves again at a Jesus Fest. This is the second annual Jesus Fest. What a blessing it is to be able to be out on a beautiful day like this and lift the Lord up, give Him praise, glory, and honor. We just want to thank Him for all the things that He does and provide for us, huh? Let's give the Lord a clap offering this morning. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. It's an honor and a privilege that we're able to be out in the community like this and sing praises to the Lord and openly give Him praise. Because there's places in this country or in this world where people can't do this kind of thing. So, as pastor's trying to run the other guy down, they told me that I was only going to be up here for 5 minutes. So, surprise. I get to take 10. All right. No problem. I can do that. You know, talking about praising the Lord, we have a little saying at our church. It goes like this. I start and say, God is good. All the time. It sounds like that's traveling around, isn't it? One more time, real loud. God is good.
All the time.
Amen, amen. You know, we can attest to that, to the miracles and the privileges and the miracles that we've seen in our lives. And God is still on the throne, isn't He? I would like to share maybe just a few minutes with you here about a scripture in Ezekiel 3:17. It says, talks about, God is talking to Ezekiel and He says, Son of man, I have made you a watchman to the community of Israel. Not community, but to the land of Israel. I may start crying here for a minute because a lot of times when I start talking about things that I'm convinced with. I may try a little bit, but you know, God came down to Ezekiel and called him out to be a watchman to Israel. And as he did that, you know, he was speaking to us as well. We are to be watchmen. We are to be watchmen for our family and our friends around the community and to reach out to those that are lost. We can't save those people, but we can reach out to them and tell them the good news that we know about Jesus Christ. What He's done for us, right? Jesus has been a steadfast thing in my life for the last 30 years. And before I knew Him, I was lost and dying and going to hell. And I thank God for opening up to me. I thank God for making me a watchman for my family, for my community, for being here tonight, for being able to be a spokesman for Him to the community. So I just reach out and say thank you to y'all for being here and supporting what we're doing here tonight. And I think we need to thank the people that put out this organization together for this Jesus Fest together. It takes them a lot of work and a lot of energy and time to do that. So, you know, we should give the people that Pastor Scott and Pastor Whitaker and all them guys that I don't know who all it is, and I can't give you all the names because I don't know all of them that have been involved. But we need to give them a round of applause and tell them thank you for putting this together. Praise the Lord for that. So, like I said, I came ready for about 5 minutes. I think I about used my 5 minutes up. But like I say, it's a privilege and an honor to be here. And as we get ready for Eric. Okay. All right. What does the Bible say? Be ready in season and out of season? You know, as we go forward into our community, Pastor Jeff was talking about the heritage that we had here, about the gentleman that was the mayor of Niles here and went on to be the president of the University of Michigan, and how the people used to come down here and camp on the river, and as they, this would be a gathering, the natives and all the fur traders and stuff would come down here and make encampments and have meetings. We have the privilege to be here and meet in Jesus' name, to meet for the Lord. This makes me go back into the Bible and read into the Bible a little bit about how Jesus went out into the communities and he walked around in the countryside and the people followed him. You know, all the people are out here gathered today worshiping the Lord. How did, think about that. We could be following Jesus today if Jesus were to come back today. Are we ready? Are we prepared for when Jesus comes back to follow him? I don't know. Yesterday, I was with our group from our church. Portage Road General Baptist Church was here yesterday and was able to come up and sing. And it was a lot of people here, and it's a privilege and an honor to be able to represent Christ. It's a privilege and an honor to be asked to come down and to represent music like this and to represent Christ. As you see, I'm kind of struggling right now a little bit with it.
All right, I'll talk.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, Steve. God bless you, my friend. So, we have some new people here, answeredprayers.org. And they have Bibles over there. And the answer for everything you need in life will be found in the Bible. Amen? So we have the elephant ears back here and other sweet shop. That's kind of the sweet shop. And then we have the prairie dogs over here. And you can buy a family meal and get something there. And just so you know, we called Eric, texted Eric, and he's supposed to be here and he's not here. So we're not sure what to do. So Andre's setting up as fast as he can. If Roy Farmer is in the house, could you please come up and sing one of your fabulous a cappella solos? So this is fantastic. God bless us. How many of you were here last year to Jesus Fest? So if you remember, the weather wasn't all that great last year. Kind of rainy off and on and chilly, yeah. So God blessed us. How many of you prayed all year, every day, for good weather for Jesus Fest? Yeah, so I know I was. I told our church, start early, man. It's important. And God hears our prayers. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So this is streaming live. You can tell your friends. Deb's here streaming things on Facebook. What that title under?
Jesus Fest on Facebook.
Jesus Fest on Facebook. So, Deb, tell us, how'd you come up with that name?
I think that was your name.
It's like the bluegrass band I had at the Bluegrass Festival, the Niles Bluegrass Band. Spent hours figuring out that name. So anyway, we're going to take a little break. Something I like to do always at church or anywhere I go. If you're sitting next to somebody, just look at the person next to you, smile first, and say, Jesus loves you. And then do the same thing to the other side. Amen. You got everybody here?